Let's go from ACX gameplay here, and today I went to Vidcon. The Fierce and Fabulous was there with Jeffree Star, Manny MUA, Patrick Starr, Miles, and Bret Man. If you guys missed it, I know you guys, a lot of you guys wanted to see it since I saw a lot of you guys posting it on Twitter. Here it goes. I taped it for you guys, so enjoy.
No one's here to see me, so I will make this easy. I'm Christina Train. I'm so excited to be here for the Fierce and Fabulous panel. I know you guys are too. We're going to serve up some tea with our favorite creators. I'm really excited because I have the opportunity to program a lot of this content with all of the beauty gurus and some of our favorite ones are here today. So without further ado, let's bring out who you really came to see. Jeffree Star!
So long.
traditional press, not just digital?
It's been absolutely amazing. You know, I'm all about breaking boundaries and trying to make a name for the boys and beauty movement. You know, it's really important to get to see all different walks of life, whether it's gender, whether it's ethnicities, and I think it's really important to show that. And the fact that traditional media is embracing it a little, but they're embracing it a little bit, so I think that's really important to show, and I feel really blessed, honestly.
Killing it.
Thank you.
And Bret Man, hi. Okay, so you just graduated high school.
Yes.
We all followed your journey from prom to graduation and all the outfit changes. I want to know what your favorite was, because mine was the cape. What was your favorite?
I really like the cape, and actually, like, a lot of people were inspired by it, especially in the Philippines back home. Everyone's tweeting me all their capes. It's so cute.
Are we going to have another cape? Are we seeing another one soon?
Maybe if I do get invited to like a cute guy's prom, then maybe I'll be there.
Together, and it's been, look at us now, it's crazy.
So that's actually a good leeway to the next questions for you, Manny, but I want to hear from all y'all. On your channel, you say that, you know, you think boys and men should have just as much recognition in beauty as everyone else. What does that mean, and what inspires you to, like, have that be so vivid on your social media?
Yeah, that was actually the first thing I ever posted on my Instagram. It was about, I think that boys deserve just as much cosmetic recognition as women do, because boys wear makeup too, boys wear makeup too. It's fun. It's, and makeup is just fun. You know what I mean? Like, for me, I'm a boy that wears makeup. I keep my facial hair. I like to dress as a boy, and I like to dress girly too. But like, it's just fun to just do what you want to do when it comes to the creativity. You know? It's like, why is it only for girls? It's really important to convey a message of unity when it comes to both, all genders, really.
Miles, what do you think about that, just giving boys the proper cosmetic props that they deserve?
I think that it's really important. I remember not too long ago, there were no boys on YouTube or on the internet doing makeup at all. And it was a kind of a scary thing for people because, you know, even in the LGBT community, there is this, you know, fear of femininity and being, girly or like a woman. And, you know, for someone who's gay to put on makeup is super taboo, and you kind of get ostracized from your own community because of, you know, you doing that. You know, you're not normal, or you're drifting farther away from the norm. So I think it's great. I think it's amazing. I think it helps people, you know, become more inclusive and, you know, more knit within the community. Now I think we need more of that in the community, honey.
So what does fierce and fabulous mean to you, Patrick Starr?
Fierce and fabulous. All y'all are fierce and fabulous. Like taking the time to listen to men and makeup. You know, I think parents out there, I think it starts at home, and if you're educated enough to support us or support equality and be kind and say hello, that's fierce in itself, because you're not shunning anyone away from you. You just gotta be a good bitch. Yes.
Lives within all of us, and they
can. So you guys have all done deals with new brands, which is amazing because it shows that mainstream culture is starting to recognize, but you guys all have your own brands as well. So I'm curious, A, what gets you to say yes to a beauty brand? And then for like Jeffree, for example, you have your own stuff going. So how do you kind of like
years old, never went back since, and I've always wanted a brand in high school. It was a dream. It never seemed attainable, and it's been a really long time coming, and, you know, I come from the music world, and I just wanted to go back to what I loved, and I just felt like there was a little bit of a void missing, a big pink void that I wanted to come fill in the beauty world, and it's opened up so many doors. And it's just cool that that's how I met a lot of these people here. And I got to collab with one of my best friends on earth. Who got that Manny bundle? And it's just
creative for that is beautiful, by the way. The photos and everything.
Oh, thank you. Yes. But for brand deals, go ahead.
I love hearing all of you about brand deals. We'll just go down the line. Manny, we'll start with you.
For me, I don't do a lot of brand deals. I don't really do a lot of them because I feel like for me, it's very important to, one, you have to love the product you're talking about. I will never promote product I don't love. You know, I will never do it. It's like, I heard early on, like, imagine if you were doing a sponsorship and you tried this product and you said that you loved it, and someone, for example, a 13-year-old, who's like working so hard, like doing chores to make this money, and bought it and they hated it. Like, that's like what like went into my head. That's been in my head ever since the beginning. And it's like, for me, I want a brand that believes in me, believes in my vision, believes that boys do deserve just as much cosmetic recognition. Not some, not just a one-off, not really, just because they want to see, not just because they want to see a new with a lot of numbers post something. But I want a true partnership, and I want it to last a while. That's what
you
mean.
Yeah, we all can't hate on him for that. That makes perfect sense. I'm sure you get brands knocking down your door. How do you say yes? How do you say no? What makes you say yes?
Well, adding on to Manny, the end of yours, I don't really, my manager's really scared to manage me at first because I was 17 and I swore a lot of my videos, and my videos are very out there, and so she was very scared to tell me in general. So a big thing that I do look for with brands that do want to work with me is like, I want them to let me, Bremen Raw, do it. I hate brands that say, you can't swear in this video. And I'm like, bitch, it's not. Then it's not Bremen Raw. It's not Bremen Raw. Like, who the fuck? And I hate like the ones that like, I film a video and I send it and then they're like, you missed this, you missed that. And I'm like,
you re-edit it.
I think the fuck not, bitch.
What about you? What makes you say yes to a brand?
Well, I think like being a plus size, you know, blogger, it has to fit me and my skin. I still got a beard under here, boo boo. It's not, you know, it just has to fit me, and I'm able to showcase the brands in a good way that works on me, because not all makeup works on me, you know, it's on my skin. So, I mean, as long as the product works and I'm in love with it, because I do have followers of all ages, all races, all sexes, I want to make sure that they be able to work on them. So that's most important to me. If it'll work on a follower, a subscriber, a family member, a friend, then it'll work on me, and that will have me move forward with that partnership.
And Miles, what about you? What gets you to say yes?
Transparency. I really love it when brands aren't afraid to take criticism. I love it when a brand is like, here, you know, try this thing out and, you know, make a video about it if you want to, and you can be honest, and, you know, so I really have to be honest with my audience. You know, if I'm reviewing something, girl, you know, I want to make sure that y'all know what it's about, and you know, and it's not just because I'm getting paid for it. I need y'all to know that, you know, I'm here for you. Like, I'm doing this brand for you. So as long as y'all know that.
It's not just about the check cash.
No, it's not.
Stay with me for a second. On your channel, you talk a lot about being gender fluid, and you're fine with any of the pronouns. Mm-hmm. Has it always been that way, or what sort of led you to want to go that route and then share it so openly and inspire people to kind of, if they feel that way, to be open about it as well?
Yeah, I feel like I've always felt this way from when I was a young little girl watching Sailor Moon in my living room. You know, one of the characters, one of the Sailor Scouts, actually, she was gender fluid as well. She looked like a boy, but then she would transform into a miniskirt, and I thought that was the coolest thing ever. And, you know, even though she was super feminine and masculine, she still, you know, she had a beautiful mixture of both. And I was like, okay, so why can't I do that and still be strong? So when I was in high school, I was just like, you know what, screw it. I let down my cornrows, I permed my hair, and I started wearing tutus and skirts and things of that nature. And I was like, yeah, this is me. If y'all don't like it, y'all can, you know, screw off. I don't care.
I'm free. Yeah, my tutu, I'm free.
Girl. Yeah.
What about the rest of you? What does, you know, gender mean? As men who wear makeup, what does gender mean to you in 2017? No, we can move on. Jeffree, on your website, you talk about discovering makeup in Cosmopolitan and different like fashion magazines. Were there any sort of supermodels or a look that you saw and you were like, okay, this is it, this is on the surface, and people move in?
I mean, I'm obsessed with Naomi Campbell. There's one. I love all the, you know, I love the, really, the Victoria's Secret models nowadays. Like, they're coming so hard. But to me, when I first discovered makeup, I just loved emulating what I saw in magazines. I would see old-fashioned magazines and just take that and try to do it on my own, you know, face. makeup is all about trial and error. You know, y'all have seen some of my old looks. That shit looks a little crazy. But it's all trial and error, just finding out what you love. And at the end of the day, it wipes off. And I think that so many people in the beauty industry get to express themselves and do whatever the hell they want. And that's what it's all about.
We started making videos and she never really knew where I was putting these until one of her coworkers confronted her for it, and she was like, what the fuck? Like, so ever since then she was always shy to go to work, and like I tried to explain to my mom how social media works and how her coworkers found it, but like she didn't get it at that. She didn't get it back then, but now she does. But also my sister and Cleo is also in my videos, and yeah, so my mom thinks I'm the breadwinner of the family, so I try to like include them in like my videos just so they could like pay me, I guess. For giving them
someone. And what about you, Miles? I saw a really fun Instagram post recently where you had all the women in your family. Like, talk about how you feel for them.
Well, it was actually when I first featured my family on my channel. I feel like it was during Thanksgiving. And I was like, will y'all make a video with me? And they were like, are we gonna be famous? I gotta see it on the TV. I'm like, no, it don't work like that, Grandma. So, yeah, they all just were like, yeah, I'm down to be in this video. And they were super relaxed. We were all at Thanksgiving. We had to do a couple takes because Grandma kept screwing up her lines. But, you know, once she got it down, it was all good. And then they're like, okay, cool. So when can we see it on TV?
My grandma did do a boomerang over Christmas, and it was a hot mess.
Right.
But we got it, so it was all good. Patrick, you often bring a lot of humor and like levity into your content. How important is it to make sure that you're serving beauty looks, but also like making your viewers laugh?
I think it's important, I think for all of us to just showcase personality. If you want your channel, show your personality, show your rainbow, shine bright. Because how many times can you watch me slam powder on my damn face? You know, it's the same thing over and over and over. So I feel like whether it's incorporating comedy in your looks or lip syncing or eating or death dropping, whatever it may be, I think it's important to showcase a different side of me each time, so they get to know a little bit more about me.
You often bring in a lot of comedy too. I think your videos are hysterical, but you come up with these amazing, beautiful looks. How important is comedy for you?
Well, I started off as like comedy on my channel. I've only been doing makeup for a year and a half, so I'm mainly comedy, so it's kind of, it just kind of comes with it. Like, I've always been a bitch, and I've always found an excuse to bitch about something, so why not include it in my makeup? So, yeah, it's just, the people like it, so thank you.
First of all, who out there is trying to be a YouTuber right now or just started a channel? Ooh, a lot of you, yes. I think the number one rule is to tell yourself to just be fearless. And I know that that's not always easy, but you just have to be your genuine self. And I know a lot of us see so many channels and so many videos sent to us. And if you're not yourself, people are not gonna connect to you. So just genuinely do what you love, be yourself, and the audience will come to you, honestly.
I completely agree, and yeah, honestly, and I feel like to add on that, I think that when it comes to YouTube, I started out and I wanted to be like people. You know, and I was like, oh my God, I want to be like her, and I want to be like her, because they were getting so many views, and they were getting so many this, and they had so many followers, and I was like, I want to be like that. But I tried doing that, and it didn't work, because I wasn't being me. And I think the most important thing is, like, they already have one of them out there, so you need to be yourself. And it's really, really important, because people always ask me, like, oh my God, like, how do I be more like you on YouTube? And I'm like, no, you have to be more like you on YouTube. So I think that's what's really important, to just convey yourself and be fearless. I say in every video, like, if you don't like it, don't fucking watch it. Yeah, just be fearless, be yourself. And honestly, the hate will come, but as long as you have a loving, caring family unit, people that love you, that's all that really matters.
You don't like it, just turn it off. That's easy.
Turn it off.
Hit off. Bret Man, what about you?
I think once you get the idea that you will have haters and you have haters. Once you get that wrapped around your head, and like, once you know that everyone has haters, like everyone here, if you don't think that you don't have haters, then I hate you, I'm kidding. But like, just, it's normal to get hate, and don't listen to them.
What about you? For people just starting out, they want to be fierce and fabulous, maybe sitting on the stage one day, what advice would you have for them?
I mean, for us specifically, I think, because we're so niche in men and makeup, what helped us, I think, was befriending each other. Like, I met Jeffree my first time I went to LA. He said, do you want to go shopping? I was like, yes. And we went to Sephora. I was like, oh my God. You remember?
And honestly, what, three years ago? 3 years, and it goes by so quick, and this is before I had even done YouTube. And yeah, seeing what him and Manny had done even inspired me to sit in front of the camera and like, look, I've been doing this for a long time, but I want to start a new adventure and try something, because I saw them being fearless, and it's the best decision I ever made.
Yeah, but continuing beyond that, if you want to start a channel, y'all are here at VidCon. There's so many of you here. Make a damn friend today. Get their Instagram, get their YouTube, subscribe to each other. Because Manny yelled at me across the street. He's like, Patrick! And I was like, who the hell is this bitch? And he was like, can I watch you do your makeup? I was like, excuse me? That's personal. I was doing my makeup in front of him, and then we became friends, and I met Jeff, and we became friends, and then next thing you know, I met Miles at a convention, and then someone wanted to FaceTime me and ask some questions, and we FaceTime, right? A lot of things. So for me, it made me feel comfortable as a gay man in makeup, but damn, I feel so good because I met someone else that looks beautiful, but different, but likes what I love. Loves YouTube as much as I do. Bret Man is funny, Miles is gorgeous. I would say like all of that. So today, make it up. My advice is be fearless, like they said, but also make a friend. Saying hello is free, being nice. You don't pay for your ticket, okay? But saying hello is free. You don't gotta pay to say hello to the next girl next to you. So I feel like if you make a friend, it'll be a lot easier for you to continue and grow your channel, because that's how you create a network.
Damn
friend,
okay. And Miles, any advice you would give people just starting out?
Well, if you already fierce and fabulous, bitch, then you already got 1 foot in the door. And now all you need is a camera. So if y'all could just, I would just say, for real, like, get yourself a camera if you don't already have one. It doesn't even need to be the best camera when you first start out. You have free reign, you know, for your first channel, your first video. Because I know a lot of us up on here might have had a first channel, and that may or may not be gone now. But, you know, you have to start somewhere. So don't be afraid to start, because starting is the hardest part. So, yeah.
So you guys change up your looks so often, clothes, hair, makeup, top to bottom. Where do you find inspiration?
Sorry, because you're
just so worthless.
I feel so weird without pink hair, but who else likes the blonde? Anyone?
Yeah. I have more fun. that
I think there's a lot of blondes out there. I think, you know, we've all experimented so much with makeup and done so many looks. It's like, what do you do next? And I just find inspiration from just looking out on the internet, and there's so many cool things that you can find on Instagram now. Who else might sit in bed for an hour and you're just on that explore page and you find some cool stuff? So I just think it's cool to see what other people are doing, and it inspires all of us to see people really pushing their creative boundaries online and just being so open. I think that's what's cool about the internet.
I would say, I mean, obviously, like, I'm really, really inspired by fellow boys of beauty. Like, my friends here, like, they inspire me every single day to keep going and creating more different looks. You know, I'm, like, not the person that wants to do extreme makeup all the time. You know, I like to just do pretty fun makeup that I can wear and I feel, like, pretty, you know what I mean? But I also am really, 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 really inspired by drag queens. I love a good drag queen. I'm like, RuPaul is my girl. So I love a good queen. I'm like, I'm just inspired. I just feel like looking at a queen, I just feel gayer. Like, more rainbow runs through my blood when I see a queen. So I'm like.
Bret Man, what about you? Where do you find your inspiration from?
Well, no offense, but I'm like the youngest one here or something like that. But. That was the second one. I don't know why I even said that, but I have a more way to go, so I'm still trying to find like that inspiration. I'm still on the experimenting phase where I really just don't, like, I just wear what I wear, like, based on trends, and if I like it, then it'll stick to me. I'm still trying to find my look. Yeah, my aesthetic.
That's interesting, because you are probably an inspiration to so many people in the audience.
Okay, it was a dress, FYI. I just cut this shit up real quick. I love drag queens.
Just trying to look at these
drag queens. At least cut it straight, man. I love drag queens. They're so fierce. I saw my first drag queen in Pulse, so I just love the community and just drag queens, and I love fashion shows, and I love watching fashion shows online and behind the scenes of Vogue and stuff like that. So I like being a good glam girl.
Give me a too long. And then Miles, where do you find your inspiration? Miles, where do you find your inspiration?
Well, back in 2000, it on MySpace with all the secret queens, but now. Definitely say that I find my inspiration from a lot of these creators up here on the stage. How about y'all? Yeah, I really love drag queens, girl. Shout out to Shea Coulee. I see you, honey. Yeah, come through. I love anime, so I'll bring it back to Sailor Moon, hunty. I love my crescent moons and the color pastel pink, so.
Okay, so we're just coming up on a few more questions, and I know there are probably people who are dying to ask a question in the audience. So, what is up next for each of you? You guys are so busy, so much going on. I feel like there's so much traveling happening. Let's start at this way and come down. Miles, what's up next for you?
I don't know how much I can talk about it, but a little hunty is doing something with YouTube Red soon.
That's so secret.
That.
Patrick, what about you?
I'm trying to look slim thick, so I'm just working on my fitness, okay? I'm not trying to get too skinny, you know, so.
Manny, what about you?
I feel like me and Jeffree should talk about it together, actually.
We may or may not be doing part two of a collaboration called Two Lives.
Perhaps.
May or may not.
And honestly, you guys, girl, breathe. Get that feeling out. Like, we had no idea our collab was gonna do, like, so crazy, like, how it did. You know, we had expectations, but they literally were so above and beyond. So we also are gonna bring back Eclipse the Highlighter for a while. And then we are doing part two where we're gonna bring back the bundle and introduce a second highlighter. Vidcon exclusive.
Vidcon exclusive, exactly. Y'all be getting out in trend new, huh?
It's your Instagram stories and your live now, give it to us.
The name is going to be Uranus. I love space.
And besides that, I'm gonna announce it for Manny. After our collaboration, he's done collabing and he's launching his own cosmetics company.
So this is the last question, and I'm going to turn it over to you guys. You guys are all extremely successful, and I know with success you can go fun places and you do fun things, buy fun things. I'm just curious what the craziest thing you maybe have purchased for yourself in the past 6 months. I'm starting with you because I was on your Instagram and
Are you trying to talk about the boomerang girl?
Do you treat yourself?
Girl, I used to come from a trailer in Huntington Beach, girl. I treat my damn self every time I can. Not to get all sappy, but me and my boyfriend just bought a house in Michigan. And we bought the house for his parents, you guys, and I think that when you are so blessed to be able to actually make money, take care of your friends and family, and you know, Nate's parents come from literally nothing, and to be able to help them out and, you know, just let them have a better life is really what it's all about. And
I'm like, I'm emotional.
Bigger and better things, as Jeffree had just said. So that should take some coins.
Starting a brand, you guys, is very difficult and it's very costly, and you know, you risk a lot.
Yeah, so I'm just saving up for my own brand in the future.
What about you, Bret Man? How have you treated yourself recently?
Yes, actually, I just bought my own little house in Hawaii. Me and my mom were always fighting, and we were just tired of each other, and she's like, it's time, you're 18, let's get out. And I like, low-key, it might sound bad, but I love fighting with my mom sometimes because she doesn't talk to me for 2 to 3 business days. So that's a break for my mom. And now that I have my own house, she still comes and judges everything that I do, as a mother would, but I mean, if I want her, I would just fight her about something, and don't come on my car.
Low-key or high-key? I think that might be a high-key.
High-key.
High
we're always fighting.
But...
Patrick, what about you? How do you treat yourself?
I save my money. I'm Asian, so we just save our money. But I treat myself by, if I'm able to fly my family out to spend time, so I don't have much time to go back home to Florida. But I did find my brother out here, so he's here somewhere. So it's just nice to spend time with your family as much as you can. Because it does get a little bit lonely sometimes, you know, when you're working so hard. We all work very hard, we have real time to see each other. So, it's my treat for my brother.
Woo! And my Miles, what about you? How do you treat yourself?
Well, honey, I did a big old splurge, and you know what I got myself? I got myself some Miss Vicky salt vinegar chips on it. It was really a big risk for me to go out of my way to get those chips. So, you know. Yeah, the more the better. moment. Yeah.
Okay, well, that concludes the Q&A portion of the afternoon. Do we have mic runners in the audience? Not okay. All right. So let's take some questions. Okay, let's take her right here with the flower crown and the color of her hair right here. Yeah. Oh, and just a couple of things, you guys. Please make sure that you, one, ask a question. Unfortunately, I'm gonna be the bad guy, so no selfies, no please say hi on my Snapchat, none of that. We wanna be respectful. So make sure you ask a question and then we'll keep it moving. One question for one of these lovely people up here and we'll keep it moving.
Hi, my name is Delaney and I have a question for Bret Man.
Hey.
Who's your celebrity crush?
Oh, I would like to say besides me, Drake is so cute, but recently I had to cut him off because I saw an interview with Rihanna and she said he had a small dick, so I was like, I'm sorry, you asked the questions. But right now, Frank Ocean, yes.
Why you put Drake on blast like that? That's not right.
Rihanna did. Just spreading the word. Just spreading the word.
Okay, do we have... Oh, wow. Okay, let's take this one in the back here. Right, yeah. On the end, yeah, you.
So, this is for, like, all of you guys. So, what's your favorite makeup look you've done?
Let's have Jeffree answer that one.
Ooh, my favorite look? Here. I've done so many. I think lately I've been really loving natural. I know that's kind of scary, but I like natural.
Stand up for us.
Hi, my name is Bailey. I got a question for Manny. What's one beauty trend or look that you will never touch? Like you just never ever want to do?
You will not see my ass. doing a whole face using fidget spinners. You got the wrong queen, honey. I'm not doing it.
Our next video, full face of fidget spinners.
What are you watching? Like, is it gonna be a lipstick? Is it gonna be like, I wanna know.
Manny cannot answer that question right now.
Yet, I have two things that I wanna watch. But there's two things that, it was what's done first. But I can't actually answer the question yet because I don't know what's gonna happen first. But yeah, I'm sorry.
Favorite creator? I love Cody Pearson.
The wild.
What's his name?
Coyote Pearson.
Thank
you. What did you say? The gag.
I like the guy that likes insects to bite him. That kind of like, I watch that. Woo!
Oh, right here, the rainbow flag. On the flag.
Trying to be that bitch, but Manny and Jeffree. Okay, I'm not gonna be a little bitch. I love you guys, and every time I tell my mom Jeffree has dropped something, she just sweats. She's like, oh no. Anyways, my question is for anyone, can you guys pussy stunt, please?
That's the thing.
Okay, let's go. Let's go over here, right here. Yeah. Do you want to come in the light? Do you want to come so we can see you?
Hi. I have a question for Jeffree.
Yeah.
Did you ever think that your brand would have the massive impact that it has now since you started?
Wow. Honestly, I had no idea I'd ever even have a brand. So the fact that in such a short amount of time, it's been only 2.5 years, it's been just receptive so well. And I think it's all, obviously all of you guys have shown it so much love. So thank you for loving the formula. But no, I never thought it could get this far this quickly. So everyone else shows me to keep going, and there's a lot of new products coming.
Hi, Kat.
Hi.
I recognize you.
Okay. Wow. Okay,
sorry. What are your guys'
favorite drag queens?
Number one is Alyssa Edwards.
This one's for Bret Man.
Hey.
Can you teach us to do the
Wow. It's one syllable. It's like one syllable. It's not it's just
Okay, let's get this guy right here with his hand and point like this. Yeah, you stand up. Yep.
Hi, my name is Louie. I just want to say,
I know you.
This is for you, Bret Man.
Oh.
So I've heard you say before that you had a lot of hate by guys in your school, like for you wearing makeup. So how did you deal with that? Because I would get some of the same things about my school. So I just want to know how you would like deal with it.
Well, I like to think about how ugly they are, bitch. Like they be teasing me like they're actually cute. Like, I hate that. Like, but they've been doing that to me since elementary, and I'm here stunting. I'm in school with my Gucci bag, bitch. You're in your jam sports, so. Call me a faggot one more time, bitch. Call me.
Not the Gucci jam sport, bro.
I'm
done. Okay, right here in the front. Oh, okay, and then we'll do her next one.
I want to say that I love you so much, and you're my inspiration, and I've been watching you for 2 years, and you literally taught me so much, and I just love you.
Love you too.
I was going to ask, like, what brand would you buy for forever if you had to choose one?
Oh my lord. Besides Jeffree Star Cosmetics, that's a hard one. How dare you do that to me, girl? God, that's tricky. I know. Honestly, besides my own, I just love so many brands that are in Sephora. Shout out to Sephora, hey. I know we all shop there. I honestly can't pick one. I can't.
Hi, guys. I just want to say you all look amazing. What is one makeup look or tip that you guys have taken that you may have regretted or say would never try again?
The full face highlighter challenge, that scarred me.
I actually really like that question. Miles, you have a look that you're like, never again.
Ooh, there's so many in my archives, girl. Which one do I choose? Definitely, which one? I did a Valentine's Day makeup where I painted my face all white with tears streaming down my face. It's definitely not a good natural look for you. Definitely not.
The person jumping with the phone with the light, right there, yeah, okay.
Hi.
Hi.
Manny, you are so inspirational. You're my total favorite.
Thank you so much.
You're adorable.
Thank you.
But my question is, this is really just a makeup question open to anybody. Whenever I put my sunglasses on, the makeup just rubs off. Is there anything I can do? And is there a difference between cooking and baking? I don't think there is.
You're so cute. Cooking and baking are basically the same thing. You're both in the kitchen and you do it well. No, honestly, I would say the one thing with the glasses is the worst. Like, we all, and we still deal with it on the daily. It's the worst thing ever. But what you can do
is try to add extra powder in that area so that the extra powder picks up a little bit more than your actual foundation does. That's what I would suggest trying.
I usually just rub it in my finger, like where the glasses were, just rub it in that area, and then it should go away,
Does anyone else have any questions like that? Because I'm trying to get some tips. Who needs some tips? That's amazing. Woo!
Okay, this is for Patrick Starr. Okay, for you, dude, I love you so much, you don't even know. For you, instead of like RuPaul, who is like your favorite RuPaul, like, Drag Race star?
Drag Race star. My first drag queen I ever saw was Roxy Andrews in Orlando, Florida, because she's thick and juicy, and I'm thick and juicy, okay? So,
make it clear.
Yeah, so I love her so much.
I also want to say, I love that you're wearing a Tupac shirt. That is amazing. Represent it. All right, all eyes on me.
Grade, and only locals in Hawaii knew back when I was just like a little fashionista on YouTube. So I've always done it, and they got used to it, honestly. I can't give you an advice because I didn't start YouTubing in high school. Like, I've done it, like, people just, I've always been on YouTube, so yeah. I can't give you an advice, I'm so sorry.
Okay, let's do her over here. We'll do it, yeah. Okay, we're gonna go, over here. We only have time for a couple more. Over here. Do you have a question?
Yes. Hi, my name is Kristen. This question is for Manny. Do you have a style icon? Like, is there somebody that you love their style?
Ooh, girl. Okay. honestly, like, I am not very good with style. I'm not really good with fashion. It's not really my thing. I don't really know how to dress myself. I'm a stylist that helps me, thank God. But I would say I love the high fashion, though. I absolutely love high fashion clothing. I think that I love Jeffree's collection of clothing. Like, this bitch has the collection to end all collections. So I walk into his closet, which not many people get to see, sadly. I walk into his closet and I'm just like...
Him and Nathan are the same shoe size.
Yes. Literally, me and Nathan are the same shoe size, so I'm always just like, hey girl, let me just try on those Gucci's, honey.
Oh, so you said you work with a stylist, Manny. Does anyone else on the stage work with a stylist?
I have one in the Philippines, but not yet.
Patrick, Miles, Jeffree, stylist, you work with a stylist?
Do I work with a stylist?
Yeah.
Oh, sweetie, I am my own stylist.
I am stylist.
Patrick, do you work with anyone?
Yeah, I have a plus size stylist. Because, I'm thick, so it's hard to find me some big clothes that look cute. If anything, like I said, I'll just cut it up myself and make it work, so.
You work it all the time. Do you work with anyone?
Sometimes I'm like,
shoots always, yeah.
Okay, we have time for maybe two more questions. Oh my goodness.
And I see this girl swimming towards me with her phone in the air, no case at all. And she was like, can we take a picture? And I'm like, we're in the middle of the ocean. You don't have a floaty. How are you floating right now? Like, it was so deep. So, I mean, that was kind of scary. Because, like, what if she drowned? Like, I can't swim, bitch. I was not about to save her. So, yeah, maybe then. But I felt like I was that bitch, bitch. Like, I get to say I took pictures with people in the middle of the ocean, which is so cute.
Okay, and then so we're gonna do this guy right here with the red sunglasses. And then actually, is there a way that the security team can just help us make it orderly, just so we can so no one gets injured or anything, like after the panel is over, to make sure everyone is okay. So let's do this here. Let's do it.
I was wondering how it feels to be like fresh out of school and really young, but yet influencing so many kids.
Fresh out of school, but I'm already like depressed. Girl, I miss high school so much. I miss like the routine and everything. But it's so hard like going to school knowing that there are eyes on you 24/7, and you just have to try and set a good example for everyone and like just pretend like there's always cameras around. If you don't want people to see that, then don't do it. Thank you. I love you guys.
Okay, we're going to take this last question here, and then we're going to go. Can we get up here?
I was not going to get that.
She's wearing white. She's getting that. Ooh.
My question is for Jeffree.
Yes.
You swim or am I?
And
I just wanted to know what your inspiration was to get rid of the brows and use highlight. Amazing.
So imagine you've been drawing on your eyebrows for 12 years, girl, my wrist needs a break. So now that we're in a highlighting obsessed world, I love highlight for brows. Is there anyone out there that has zero brows in the audience? Anyone? See, there's like one person, so it's a scary risk because when you have no makeup on, you do look a little crazy. So if you're thinking about it, don't do it because your brows are snatched.
Okay, well, I want to thank Miles, Patrick Starr, Bret Man, this amazing panel, first graduates. You guys, please disperse.
All right, guys, so I hope you guys enjoyed the video, first off. Second of all, you guys are amazing, you guys are awesome. Third, if you can, please give this video a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button down below. Alright, until next time, bye.